would like you to meet Sylvester. We don't know what his name is, but when I looked at the picture I got from the person who found him, that's what just jumped into my mind. So he's got a little scar on his nose, and I thought, well, you know, like in Rocky, Sylvester Stallone's nose took a beating too, so it seems like a good name to me.
I thought Sylvester the Cat, because of black and white.
Oh, there you go. So it works on two levels. I had an email just this week that said, this husky wandered into our yard this afternoon. I was hoping your rescue could take him in. He's been scanned for a microchip and none was found. I posted him on Lost Pet Alert with no luck. He's a young, intact male. He's skinny, but otherwise seems healthy. I did bathe him and found fleas, but other than the healed scratch on his nose, he doesn't seem to have any injuries. We have two female dogs that he's gotten along with so far, and he's done well with my children, ages 8 and 4. He mostly ignores them, although he does follow our younger dog around, and likes to follow our daughter around, and me more than my husband and son. I'm sorry, I kind of stumbled over that. Sounds like he likes the younger dog and the females better than the males in the household. She said, he's not food aggressive, ate out of a bowl while I held it. And I'm going to stop reading this for just a second because I talked to her on the phone. And the sweetest thing, she said he wouldn't eat and was really skinny. But when she would hold the food bowl in her hand and hold it out to him, he would just eat and eat and eat. So definitely not food aggressive. Not sure why that is, but obviously loves people given that. She said he was unfazed by the car ride to the vet. He laid in the seat and fell asleep. He doesn't. We don't think he's housebroken or else he's marking, as he pottied a couple times inside. Now, he is young. He is unneutered. They do have dogs, so that could be marking, or he may just need some housebreaking, but you know, they're young, and huskies tend to figure that out pretty quickly. He did not like being sprayed with water in the bath, but other than that, he didn't fight me at all. He even laid down at one point while I was scrubbing him. So you can really, now you did, before I forget, Bev, you said he was maybe a little head shy?
He was a little hesitant to let me put the leash on his collar.
Okay.
He wasn't snappy, he just kind of leaned away.
Sometimes. Okay. Okay, well, we don't know, obviously, what his background is. She said another woman about 3 miles away actually found him at 11 o'clock yesterday. This was, well, said Monday. I don't know what day it was. Very short in between. He escaped her yard as soon as she had posted him, and then he ended up in ours. He hasn't tried to escape our yard, but I can tell you he definitely does not like being crated. He made some noise when they tried to put him in the crate. We're unable to keep him past today, so I was hoping you could take him. Otherwise, I've left a message to get an appointment at Animal Control. I don't want to take him there. I'm really hoping you can help. I talked to this lady on the phone, really nice lady. She is, both of her dogs are adopted rescues that were her fosters in the past. She fostered from another organization and she foster failed on them. And her husband kind of wanted to keep this guy, but she said, you know, just honestly, I have a 4-year-old, an 8-year-old, 2 dogs, and you know, I don't have the energy or time that this dog deserves. In her intake notes, she said he's calm and relaxed, follows me around, mostly ignores my husband. Some of this might be repetitive, but I'm just going to go through it fast. He's done very well around my children, ages 8 and 4. He follows them around the yard, doesn't jump on them or run at them at all, shows zero signs of aggression. With strangers, he's a bit trepidatious, but he warmed up to us very quickly. He wasn't interested when we offered him toys. He was with 2 female dogs, a 6-year-old black lab chow mix, and a 3-year-old female pit bull mix, and has done fine, especially seemed to like our pit bull mix, and no aggression at all with either dog. She has no idea about cats. Help me remember, we will at least judge a reaction on that. Again, we brought him indoors for a bath. Otherwise, he's been outside, and they put him in the crate, which overnight, but again, he didn't do well. So he would need some work on that, or somebody that can just teach him how to be in the house. We had a 4-foot chain link fence. He made no effort to escape. He does not respond to commands that I've been able to see. Have you tried anything with him, Bev?
Do you know sit? Sit? Give me a paw.
He said, give me a treat.
He said he likes the treats well. Yeah. He does not bite
vendors. Okay, so he took that very gently. He said he didn't pull on the leash when he took him to the vet. And in the car, he just laid down and fell asleep. How he seemed good on the...
Chewing my thumb.
Aw. Like a pacifier.
Yeah.
Aw. And he ate food out of that bowl. Okay. So her closing comments were, he seems very well-mannered, done exceptionally well around my children. He shows no food aggression. Seems like a wonderful companion that just needs to be house-trained and really wants to be around us. He doesn't... let's see. The last thing I have is when the person who found him brought him to the kennel owner here said he is very sweet and laid back. She said the lady has 2 kids, 4 and 8, and he was so good with them, they were all over him. So if you're looking for a young dog that's good with kids, I think this is your guy right here. And we're going to try the kiss cam, and then we'll take some pictures.
And he's a handsome guy, too.
He's very handsome. And I don't mean to be, I know I'm sounds like I'm running through these videos, but we have nine dogs today, and I've already had low battery warning on my first one. So we got to get through them fast, but we had a lot of good things to say about you. Give me the kiss cam. Hi. Will you want to suck my thumb?
He's got an unusual shade of blue in his eyes, too.
Do you? Let's see. Yeah, they're kind of violet, aren't they? He does have kind of violet blue eyes. I don't know if it'll show up. He's a good boy. Beautiful markings on his face.
Love the white garters.
And not a big boy. I mean, he's probably 50? I mean, probably 50.
He's 50,
probably
45. Okay. He is a little thin.
Yeah. So that's a good boy. He just wants somebody to hold his food bowl, huh? Give his kiss. Good boy, Sylvester. Quick addendum to this, because I didn't say, his teeth are pearly, pearly white. He hasn't been to our vet yet, but Bev knows, has met a lot of dogs. She thinks just a year, maybe barely over a year. So he's just a puppy. Back to pictures. Okay, Sylvester? Where are those kitties? You see him, don't you?
Well, those calicos up there are still freaked out.
Yeah.
Because that first one went after him. Now he's looking up there at him, he sees him.
But not real excited. Okay.
So excited,
that's as good as it's going to get today.